Welcome, this is Dr. G, and in this video, I will be introducing how to use molar volume in the context of STP and SATP to help convert between moles and volume in your mole conversion questions. This is usually introduced after you've learned molar mass and Avogadro's number, so if you haven't done so already, make sure to check out my videos on molar mass and Avogadro's number up there. You got this. Come on, let's go. Molar volume is the volume that's occupied by one mole of a particular substance. We can therefore set it up as a ratio of a given amount of volume per one mole, or we can flip it around and say it's one mole over a given amount of volume in liters. Of the two, the technical definition of what molar volume is going to be your X amount of volume per one mole. However, in a chapter of mole conversions, it doesn't really matter. It really depends on the question and what units you want to cross out, so feel free to choose between the two ratios when you're doing your questions. As a side note, I'm using liters here for volume. However, if you're doing AP chemistry or IB chemistry, you'll probably see something like centimeters cubed or decimeters cubed or even meters cubed instead of liters or milliliters, because those are actually the standard international units for volume. And also, instead of writing it as per mole or over mole, they might write it as mole to the power of negative one. It means the exact same thing, so just keep that in mind. Here is an equation that you might come across for molar volume. The big M here represents the molar mass, and the P represents the density. Now, this equation isn't that useful because we can only use it when we have constant temperature and pressure, known as STP. When we're at STP, which we'll talk about a lot today in this video, our molar volume will actually be the same number for all ideal gases. It's going to be a constant. So that's why this equation here is just for your information. You most likely will not need to use this information at all. What you will need to know is to how to convert between moles and volume. In my previous videos, I explained how to go from moles to molecules and atoms, as well as to go back and forth between moles and mass. Now, the last one here is volumes, and it's a little bit tricky because there's actually two different ways to convert from moles to volume, although you don't have a choice. The first one is what we're going to do in this video, and that's to convert from moles to volume when you're dealing with gases. And in that case, you'll be doing this in either SATP or STP. Again, this video will be focused on how to do these questions at STP or SATP, so we'll talk about that in just a second. The second way to convert between moles and volume is when you're dealing with solutions, and that will be covered in the next video. Let's talk about STP, which stands for standard temperature and pressure. The standard temperature is pretty straightforward. It is 273.15 Kelvin, which is equivalent to 0 degrees Celsius. In chemistry, we do prefer to use kelvins, so try to use that instead of the degrees Celsius. When it comes to standard pressure, it used to be 1 atmosphere and all the equivalents, as you can see, listed underneath. However, now we use 1 bar as our standard pressure, and the difference between the two is actually quite minimal. They're very similar units to measure pressure. However, we do not use 1 atmosphere as our standard pressure any longer. We use 1 bar. Knowing what standard temperature and pressure is great, but it's not extremely important in the context of mole conversions. What you need to know for mole conversions is that when you see in a question that our compound or substance is a gas, and the question specifically states that it's in STP or it's at STP, then we automatically are allowed to use the ratio of 22.7 liters per one mole. Of course, you can always flip it around and write it as 1 mole per 22.7 liters. And that's pretty much it for STP. So the significance of STP is not in its actual standard temperature and pressure numbers. You don't have to memorize those. The significance is that when you see the words STP in a question, you know in the back of your pocket, you're allowed to use the 22.7 liters per 1 mole ratio to help you solve the question. For those that are wondering, how do we know it's 22.7 liters per 1 mole? Or why is it always 22.7 liters per 1 mole when we're at STP? Here's the reason why. So to understand why, we have to use the ideal gas law, and the equation is PV equals nRT, where P is the pressure, V is the volume, N is the moles, R is the gas constant, and T is the temperature. Out of these letters, we're interested in the volume and the moles because we're talking about molar volume right now. And the only constant here we have is the gas constant, which makes the pressure, volume, moles, and temperature variables. Well, if we have four variables, that's pretty hard to figure out a ratio or a pattern for specifically the volume and the moles, isn't it? Which is why under STP, we have standardized or kept constant the pressure, which is 1 bar, and the temperature, which is 273.15 Kelvin. So because of STP, now the pressure, temperature, and gas constants are all constants, and the only variables we have is the volume and moles. If we were to isolate the volume and the moles onto one side, we can end up with the example on the left where we have V over N equals to RT over P, or the flipped version of that works as well. If we kept the ratio of volume to moles as volume over moles, or V over N, notice that the units will end up becoming liters over mole, which is one of our molar volume units. And if we're to do moles over volume, or N over V, then the units will end up being moles over liter, both of which are fair game for us to use to solve questions in the mole conversion chapter. Let's take a look and see how this equation rearranged to have V over N is always going to give us the 22.7 liters per mole that we see at STP. The temperature STP we know is 273.15 Kelvin. The pressure is 1 bar. And because we're using Kelvin and bar, the number we use for the gas constant R is going to be this. Now, the gas constant R has many different values depending on which units of pressure and temperature and volume and moles you're using, but that will be covered when I actually talk about gas laws in a separate video. If we plug in the numbers where these variables used to be, it would end up something like this, and notice that the bars will cancel out as well as the Kelvins. So we're going to be left with liters with a mole negative 1, which means liters per mole. So you see how that gives us the units that we want. And if we're to crunch in the numbers, we'll end up with 22.7 liters over 1 mole. If we did this with the other version of the equation where we have the moles on top and volume at the bottom, it would be the exact same thing. We would do the exact same, but we'll just end up with a 22.7 liters on the bottom with 1 mole on the top. If you've already started this chapter and your teacher is not using 22.7 liters per mole as STP, but 22.4 liters per mole, that's not a mistake. There's a reason for that. Remember earlier when I said that the standard pressure used to be 1 atmosphere and not 1 bar? If you use 1 atmosphere as our pressure at STP, we will end up with 22.4 liters per mole. Here's how it happens. We'll use the same temperature at STP, but this time we'll use 1 atmosphere for our pressure. And because our units are atmospheres in Kelvins, we use a different number for our gas constant. So if we're to put these values into the equation, we can see we can cancel out the atmospheres again, and we can cancel out the Kelvins, leaving us with liters per mole, which is good. And if we crunch into numbers, we'll end up with 22.4 liters per mole, or if we'd flip it around, it would be 1 mole per 22.4 liters. On that note, most teachers will be using 22.7 liters per mole for STP, but some teachers are more old school, right? They're more traditional. They're used to using 22.4. Stick with whatever number your teacher wants you to use. Let's now move on to SATP, which looks similar to STP, and it actually is very, very similar conceptually to STP. SATP stands for standard ambient temperature and pressure, and the word ambient just means room. So it's standard room temperature and room pressure. So ambient temperature or room temperature is no longer 0 degrees Celsius, of course. It is around 25 degrees Celsius arbitrarily, which we give 298.15 Kelvins. The room pressure should be the same as just any other pressure, so that will be 1 bar as usual. Again, the significance is not remembering the actual temperature and pressures, but it is to know that when you see a gas in a question at SATP, we will not use 22.7 liters per mole, but we are allowed to use 24.8 liters per mole and 1 mole over 24.8 liters, vice versa. How do we get the 24.8 liters per mole? Same as how we got it in STP. We use our ideal gas law equation, plug in the values for T, P, and R, crunch it in, do some calculations, and we'll get 24.8 liters per 1 mole. If we were to do this the other way around, then we would just get 1 mole over 24.8 liters, both of which you can use to help you solve questions in mole conversions. Speaking of questions, let's take a look at this example here. How many atoms of oxygen are present in a beaker filled with 50 milliliters of carbon dioxide gas at STP? Before even going into what we want and what we have in this question, let's look right off the bat at the fact that there is a gas at STP. That means we are allowed to use the 22.7 liters over 1 mole, or the vice versa of that, of course. It doesn't mean we have to use it, but more often than not, you're going to probably need to use it. Okay, knowing that, let's now go back to the question and do what we always do for mole conversion questions. Let's figure out what we want, which is the atoms of oxygen, and what do we know, or what do we have, which is 50 milliliters of carbon dioxide. And of course, starting with what we know, which is 50 milliliters of carbon dioxide, do we want to keep the units of milliliters of carbon dioxide? Absolutely not, which means we have to multiply it by a ratio with milliliters of carbon dioxide on the bottom. What ratio can we put with milliliters? Well, I know that a gas at STP, I can use 22.7 liters per mole, so that seems good. But I'm not even at liters right now, I'm at milliliters. So let's convert this to liters of carbon dioxide first. And this is just like a unit conversion, 1 liter over 1,000 milliliters. And now we can cross out the milliliters and we're left with liters, which of course we do not want. So liters of carbon dioxide goes on the bottom on the next ratio. And I can now get to moles. Again, am I allowed to use moles and liters in a ratio? Yes, in this video, we just learned that we can always use 22.7 liters with 1 mole as long as there's gas and STP in the question. So the number 1 goes with the moles, the 22.7 goes with the liters, and we can cross out the liters, and we are now at moles. They don't want moles, they want atoms of oxygen, so we're not done. So continuing on here, we're going to multiply moles of carbon dioxide on the bottom because we don't want that. Can we go from moles to atoms of oxygen right away? We cannot, because our moles is of a compound or a molecule called carbon dioxide, but they want an atoms of oxygen. So we can only go from moles to molecules of carbon dioxide, and that is our Avogadro's number, which we learned before, and we can now cross out the moles. We are now at molecules of carbon dioxide. We don't want molecules, so we're going to put that on the bottom, and we are allowed to put molecules of carbon dioxide with atoms of oxygen, because in every single carbon dioxide in the world, there's always 2 atoms of oxygen per 1 molecule of carbon dioxide, because it's CO2. And now we can cross out the molecules of carbon dioxide, and we're left with atoms, which is what we want. If we're to crunch the numbers, this is the answer that we will get with the correct sig figs, which is 4 sig figs because of the 50.00 milliliters of carbon dioxide. Let's take a look at another example. How much volume in milliliters with 3.5 micrograms of N2O, or nitrous oxide, take up at SATP? First things first, we notice that our compound, nitrous oxide, is a gas and it is at SATP, which means we're allowed to use the 24.8 liters per 1 mole ratio. Of course, you can use the foot version of that as well if needed. Now let's focus on the actual question. What do they want? They want the volume. And what do we know? We know the 3.5 micrograms of nitrous oxide. So let's start with what we know, which is the 3.5 micrograms of nitrous oxide. Do we want micrograms in the answer? Absolutely not. So we got to get rid of it and put it on the bottom here so we can cross it out. But we can't really do much with micrograms because molar mass is with grams and moles, not micrograms. So we want to get to grams first, which is a unit conversion. And we can write it as 10 to the negative 6 grams is equivalent to 1 micrograms. At this point, we can cross out the micrograms and we're left with grams, which is good, but not great because we want milliliters and not grams. So we have to get rid of grams of nitrous oxide on the bottom. And on the top, we can put it with moles for molar mass. The molar mass of N2O would be 44 grams per 1 mole. We can cross out the grams, leaving us with moles, We're not there yet, so we have to get rid of moles. And what do we want to put with moles? I mean, the question wants milliliters, but we can't do moles with milliliters, can we? There's no such ratio. We can only do moles with liters, and that's the molar volume. Since it's SATP, we're going to put 24.8 liters to 1 mole, and we can now cross out the moles, leaving us at liters of N2O. Unfortunately, they want milliliters, so we have to do one more unit conversion at the end here, get rid of our liters, introduce the milliliters, and we can write, of course, as 1 milliliter is equivalent to 10 to the power of negative 3 liters, and we can cross out the liters, finally leaving us with what we want, which is the milliliters. We can crunch in these numbers in a calculator, and we'll get a number that looks like this. But for proper sig figs, which is 3 sig figs, we can write our answer in scientific notation, let's say, and it will be 1.97 times 10 to the power of negative 3 milliliters of N2O. So as a recap, we have now done one of the two pathways between moles and volume. And again, this pathway that we did, which is the STP or the SATP, they're very similar, so I'm going to put them in the same pathway here. These only work when we're at gas, when we have gases, as well as we see the letters STP or SATP written in the question. That means the question is presumably under the conditions of STP and SATP. If you're dealing with a question that you're mixing solutions or, you know, acids and whatever, you can't just use 24.8 or 22.7 liters per mole just because they want liters and you have moles or something. You can't just use that if you want. You can only use these if you have gases and they specifically tell you you're at STP or SATP. And that is it for molar volume, STP, and SATP. If you liked the video, give the video a like, and if you really like the video, subscribe to the channel and help it grow. If you have any questions, comments, and topic requests, you can always put it down in the comment section down below.